An 8-gun salute with a 30-minute interval was fired from dawn until dusk in the Philippine Army's headquarters in Taguig Monday to commemorate the death of former President Fidel V. Ramos, who passed away Sunday at the age of 94. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. declared a period of national mourning for 10 days. All Philippine flags will be raised at half-staff, while soldiers will wear black armbands for a month as a symbol of mourning Ramos, a skilled soldier who rose from lieutenant to general to chief of the armed forces before he was elected as the 12th president of the Philippines. Former Socioeconomic Secretary Shelito Habito says Ramos's skills were further highlighted when his administration faced the financial crisis that crippled nearly all countries in Asia.
One of the trademarks of President Ramos was he was known for assembling summits. We call them summits at that time, big multisectoral meetings where the leaders of different sectors of society would come together. And that is what led to the social reform agenda. It is also what led to a lot of these reforms that include the privatization of water services, especially in Metro Manila.
Jojo Terencio, Ramos's former presidential writer, says one of the late president's toughest calls was to sell several government businesses and properties.
Isa pa yung nakikita ko mga comments ngayon na siya si Boy Benta. Boy Benta, di ba? The privatization. Parang yung connotation kasi nga ngayon, parang binenta mo lahat ng ari-arian ng gobyerno. But at that time, coming out of the economic crisis, coming out from the EDSA revolution, wala namang pondo ang gobyerno, di ba? So what do? You instead of raising taxes, di ba, you have to tap the white elephant assets of the government.
Another victory of the Ramos administration is the signing of a peace deal between the government and the Moro National Liberation Front, which ended a nearly three-decade secession movement in Mindanao. Former Solicitor General Silvestre Bello III says this was possible because of FVR's so-called bibingka strategy when it comes to resolving conflicts. Bibingka is a Philippine rice cake that is baked by placing charcoal at the top and at the bottom of the pan.
Yung bibingka niya kasi when there is a problem, he said na para maayos mo yung problema, kailangan pakinggan mo ang both sides. So you put it on the top and put it on the bottom. Para sa ganoon, sabi niya, mapapag-meet mo yung dalawang conflicting position.
He also remembers FDR's grueling work ethic.
6 o'clock, maniwala ka sa akin, meron ka na matatanggap na newspaper item with clippings and then with this marginal note. Ganon kaaga ang trabaho ng ating Pangulo. Ganon sa kaano. Hardworking and ang ganon din ang expectation na from the members of his cabinet.
While Ramos was a key figure in Philippine politics, former Senator Franklin Drilon, who served as Ramos's Justice Secretary, says the late president never played politics.
To him, politics is what is good for the country. I would follow his lead, I'd follow his qualities, because I knew it was born out of his experience also as being involved in the law and order sector of our country. During those times, he gave the full support for the prosecution of those who have transgressed the law.
Ramos's family has yet to give details about his wake and burial. They asked for some privacy to mourn not just the death of a well-decorated general and a former president, but the demise of a loving father and a doting grandfather. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.